I remove the battery.
Objection.
Sustained. You've taken all the leeway you're getting, Mr. McGill. Wrap it up fast.
God, Jimmy.
Don't you know by now this is real? I feel this. It's a physical response to stimuli. It's not a quirk. What do I have to do to prove it to you?
I don't know, Chuck. Could you reach into your breast pocket and tell me what's there?
What now?
Tell the court what that was.
Battery.
Mr. Chairman, please.
You recognize that man in back? His name is Huel Babineau. He's on our witness list. You bumped into him in the stairway. He'll testify he planted this fully charged battery on you over an hour and a half ago. An hour and 43 minutes. Thank you, Mr. Babineau. And you felt nothing.
No. It's a trick. It has
enough to. Is enough. I submit that Mr. McGill's mental illness is a non-issue. If he was schizophrenic, it wouldn't take away from the fact that the
I
defendant...
I am not crazy! Not crazy. I know he swapped those numbers. I knew it was 1216. One after Magna Carta, as if I could ever make such a mistake. Never. Never. I just couldn't prove it. He covered his tracks. He got that idiot at the coffee shop to lie for him.
Mr. McGill, please, you don't have to go.
You think this is something? You think this is bad? This chicanery? He's done worse. That billboard. Are you telling me that a man just happens to fall like that? No, he orchestrated it. Jimmy. He defecated through a sunroof. And I saved him. And I shouldn't have. Took him into my own firm. What was I thinking? He'll never change. He'll never change. Ever since he was 9, always the same. Couldn't keep his hands out of the cash drawer. But not our Jimmy. Couldn't be precious Jimmy. Stealing them blind. And he gets to be a lawyer? What a sick joke. I should have stopped him when I had the chance. And you have to stop him. You,